I'm going to be an opportunity to redeem it now. It's not my first loss being here.
It's just absolutely a blessing for my family and I. The people around town, the people on campus have just accepted us, made us feel like this is our new home. Wonderful people at every level. I've got great returners coming back, great recruiting class coming in. We just can't be even more excited than what we are today, and just looking forward to getting to work.
Coach, being a Louisiana native, how familiar is your with Northwestern State as well?
I was very familiar, actually. I had always heard about the mystique of Natchitoches and the people, and knew about the Christmas traditions. Actually, I used to swing through all the time to enjoy the Christmas festivities. But actually now being a part of the process, you really see what people are talking about. And it's just a great place not only to work, but a great place to raise a family.
And how long have you known the Storm?
Coach Storm and I, my first year at Southern Miss, I had come in newly hired, and then Brooke had come in. Actually, came from Louisiana Tech, and her and I immediately bonded. A lot of philosophies were the same things that I lacked in certain areas. She was there to help pick me up and kind of mentor me, and we've just stayed in touch ever since. We just love watching each other's kids grow up, and the fact that she's done such a great job here is going to make my job a whole lot easier.
You guys were able to meet at Southern Miss. You spent so much time there in Hattiesburg. How much did that shape you as not only a coach, but as a man?
It shaped me a bunch. And the thing that I admire about Scott and Brooke is their balance between their family and their job. They always did such a great job of balancing the two, and that's something that's very important to me. I want to make sure that I continue to do that. And Brooke showed me that. She laid that groundwork for me, and I always bounce ideas off of her and Scott. And they've always been there whenever I needed a boost or anything like that, and here they are. Laying the groundwork for this wonderful program for me to step in and walk into. It's a really special time. First order of business, like I said, is going to be hire a good staff. That's first and foremost. Our recruits are locked in and they're ready to come. Nancy's done a great job from an academic standpoint, having everybody set up. Our schedule is done. So really the biggest thing is communicating with coaches, hiring a good staff, and then getting them recruits. There has been. There's been opportunities. But again, you know, Hattiesburg was always a special place. I worked for a special woman that gave me all kinds of opportunities to learn and to grow. And the things that she's done in order to shape me in my career, I wasn't just going to leave. It had to be a pretty special place. And that's where Natchitoches come in. She said, look, this is the job you need to get. This is a special place. You're ready. I've prepared you, and she's right. I believe I'm ready. And, if I need to, I can always call her and get advice.
When you got the job officially and it was secured, what kind of advice did Coach McNellis give you about what you needed?
She always just told me about being organized. That's really the biggest thing that I've learned from her. She's done a great job preparing me to handle every aspect of the program. She said, make sure you surround yourself with good people. Make sure you surround yourself with people that you'll want to work with every single day. People that are going to have a smile on their face every single day. People that are going to grind for you and for the university. There's really no words that I can honestly say to thank her enough. They pulled me from high school and gave me an opportunity for now 8 years later.
You've been telling me you got it. Let's talk about the roster.